Hello, welcome to the WebAPIC channel. In this video, we will be looking at how we can create a feed by using our plugin CTX Feed and uploading into Pinterest catalog. So without further ado, let's get started and find out how exactly we can achieve this. Let's go into our plugin CTX Feed and go ahead and create a new feed. So click on Make Feed. After you've clicked on that, you'll see this page where you need to choose the country that you're making this feed for. In this case, I'll choose the United States. And then out of all the templates that we have available, we also have a template available for Pinterest catalog. So right now I'm going to choose that template. Let's rename the file pintest1. I'll keep the feed type as XML, and item wrapper and single item wrapper can remain as product and product respectively. Since we have chosen the template Pinterest catalog, we'll see that the feed config is automatically populated with all the different Pinterest attributes that we need. Now if we scroll down, let's look at some of these attributes that we have. Now we can see that one of the attributes that is being used is called Google Product Category. In this case, there is no category that is chosen at the moment. So I'm going to choose apparel as an example of all the products that we'll be uploading into Pinterest catalog. Now let's scroll down and we can see regular prices, and the suffix here is incorrect because the feed that we are making is for US. So I'm going to change this to US dollars. I'm going to do that for the sale price as well. So I'm going to convert that to USD. Now we can make other changes like manufacturer being the brand we're uploading all these products for. So I'm just going to name this my brand. However, you can keep this as a dynamic attribute that picks up things automatically, or you can keep it as pattern, and everything that will be uploaded will be named the exact same thing in this case, which is my brand. Now I think we have everything in order, so we're going to go ahead and click on update and generate feed. This will only take a few seconds, and right now as we can see, we have our feed and it's ready to go. Pinterest 1, this is our feed URL, so I'm going to keep this copied. Right now I'm going to jump into Pinterest catalog and I'm going to show you how we can upload this feed that we have generated in Pinterest catalog. Right now we're inside Pinterest, and to be specific, we're inside Pinterest Hub. This is where you want to be if you want to upload and connect your catalog. If you scroll down, you can see one of these options that tells you to connect your catalog. So I want you to go ahead and click on this button, Connect Catalog. Now you will be redirected to this page that says Catalogs, and you'll see all the different catalogs that you might have uploaded earlier. Now since we have created a new feed, we're going to click on Add New Data Source. So go ahead and click on that. After you've done that, you get to name your feed, and then I'm going to fill this up, Pintest. I'm going to name this 4 because I've done some previous examples. Since we have copied our product feed from here, which I'll do once again, I've just copied it. I'm going to go ahead and paste it here. Now the file format, I'm going to keep it as XML because when we created our feed, we kept it as XML as well. Default availability, if you want, you can choose in stock, out of stock, or pre-order. In this case, I'll just keep it as none, and I'll let the software determine it as it is. Now you have username and password. If you created a username and a password when you created your feed to protect your feed, you want to put it in here so the file can be accessed. But in this case, I'm going to keep it as empty. Now you get to choose the country and region. I'm going to keep it the same as when I created my feed, which is United States. So I'm going to keep it as it is. The language as English, and the default currency as US dollars. So this is all perfect. You get to choose the time when your feed is ingested or uploaded. So I'm just going to give this a random time. The time zone, you change it to whatever you want to. I'm just going to keep it as it is. Then I'm going to go ahead and create pins. Now you can see that it says validation complete, file validation complete. Now, it does take a bit of time for the data to be processed and to be uploaded. Now, as you can see, it says you'll receive an email about data source verification within 24 hours. So unlike Google and Facebook, Pinterest does take a bit of time for them to check the data that you have already uploaded. So go ahead and click on continue. After going through that process, we can see the new data source that we have uploaded. Right now, we can see that the status isn't pending. And if we scroll down here, we can also see that the report status is also in processing. So now all we have to do is just wait. Please note that sometimes when you have created a new data source, it might not immediately come up on this page. So you might have to just refresh your page and then you'll be able to see it. As I've told you earlier, unlike Facebook and Google, this does take a bit of time. So you might have to wait a little bit longer to see if there's any errors in the feed that you have just uploaded here. After waiting for a while, when I came back and refreshed my page, I could see that the status has changed to inactive, which means my feed upload has been complete. Or you could have also received an email saying that your feed upload is done. Now let's go ahead and see the status of our upload. As you can see under report status, we can see it has failed. Now we can see the report and see the issues right here. So let's see what the problems were. Like Google and Facebook feed uploads, when you scroll down, you can actually see all the different items that might have been affected due to the error message. Now we can see that in this case, it has been the Google product category which errored out, and these are exactly the items that have been affected. So right now you can easily go back to your feed and you can try to fix all these issues. If you also want, you can download the entire report by clicking on this button. If you want to learn more about the tips and the best practices for you to upload your feed into Pinterest without any issues, you can always click here and read up about it. Once you have fixed all the different error messages and gotten rid of them, you'll see that the status will have changed from inactive to active. This means all the products that you've uploaded using the feed now are successfully within Pinterest catalogs. Now, if you want to make changes to your data sources, you can always click on this button and make necessary changes if you need to. So that is it, guys. This is how you can upload data using CTX feed into Pinterest catalogs. Now, if you have any issues or troubles when you're trying to upload your data, you're always welcome to reach out to us. You can reach out to us at support@webappic.com. I hope everybody liked this video and found something useful. Please leave us a like in this video and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody have a good day. Thank you very much.